Hello, my beautiful Geminis. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. Hope everyone's doing well. Thanks for stopping by, and all cross watchers are also welcome. Your person's thoughts, feelings, action, and intentions are laid out in front of you with clarifiers. The overall energy that they are bringing in is grace and generosity. They want to be your benefactor in some way, Gemini. The wailing tree, they want a reconciliation, or they want to reconcile some sort of problem or difficulty they might see in the relationship. Deep quiet, meditation, and stillness. They definitely are giving things a lot of thought. So when they think of you, they see you as somebody who's very romantic, very sweet, very enticing. The high priestess is Cancerian energy, Pisces energy. You know, they want to give you a bouquet of flowers. They want to give you a love note. They want to woo you. They see you as very innocent, very sweet, very kind, and very loving. When they think of you, they definitely want to have a victory with you. They feel as though, you know, that could be a little bit egocentric energy. They're in it for winning your heart, and you haven't responded very well. We get the Eight of Cups here. They feel as though they've failed and that you really aren't that interested in them, Gemini. They want to heal whatever has gone on in this relationship. They have a lot to tell you. So they are thinking about how to move this situation forward, how to tell you what they really feel, what they're doing, what they're up to. In terms of their feelings and their heart space, they want to make a huge offer. That's a diamond ring. When we look at the tarot, it's a substantial offer in love. They're coming in with this energy of, let me take care of you. Let me be your benefactor. I want to be generous with you. It's the daddy card. It's a card that says, you know, don't worry about anything. Gemini, want to take care of you. When they, in their heart space, they definitely are obsessed with you. The devil energy is here. Your person is, you know, really has this sort of wailing tree, definitely intended and intend on a reconciliation or working through the energies that caused you to release them. So whatever happened in the relationship, it looks like they've been controlling, probably manipulative, but it, you know, you are in this energy of wanting to be free, wanting to be very straightforward, that your response to this is, you know, no, I'm living the good life here, Gemini, this is you. This is you saying, no, I'm not going to have any devil energy today. Take it off the buffet table, not for me. And Gemini, it shows that they feel as though you pass judgment on them, that you were very aloof, very dedicated to the truth, that the truth of the matter is that you don't want relationship in the same way, and you've made it really clear. Nobody's going to be the boss of a Gemini. We get devil energy, we see someone who likes to be in control, and that's what they think. Well, I'll just control and show Gemini everything I want. Gemini says, no, I'm a free spirit. I don't really let anybody hold on to me. I release them because I use my intellect to make a decision about how pure the energy is. So this is Aquarius energy. It's very smart. It's all about the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. The truth is nobody can hold you back. You don't want a benefactor. You just want a very deep, committed relationship based on being successful. When we look at their intentions with you, they're coming in. Look at, we have the Knight of Swords coming in towards you. We have the Chariot coming in towards you. This person wants to tell you the truth. They're hoping that you will listen. They're hoping that you will respond. Your person may have put you for a period of time into a competitive situation. They might not have closed off their dating, and they may have been in touch with other people from the past, and you're not having it. You know, you're standing in your power. You're in this Nine of Pentacles energy, and you're staying in your happy space. You're letting go and releasing and moving forward. You know, you're actually the one who's going to get this energy of victory here. That's what I'm feeling very strongly. So when we look at the energy that they have, Six of Cups, they want a reunion with you. They want this very nurturing. They want to be softer. They want to tone it down. They don't want to, you know, their intention is to back off being so forceful with you, pursuing you so hard, and nurturing you instead. When we look at their actions, they're trying to stay balanced. Temperance is a number one card of reconciliation. And we also have reconciliation here, the wailing tree. So your person, again, has this, is feels compelled to win. There are a lot of sixes, six of wands, six of wands. Your person is in it to win it. They want to make a very public display of your relationship. And in the right mode, you would accept it, but you're going to make sure that they don't have any manipulative energy. The Two of Wands says that in terms of their actions, they are making the decision. They want to capture your heart. They want you to experience the same feeling they have, joy, happiness. The Ten of Cups is a happily ever after, the mom, the dad. You know, it's pure joy, it's pure happiness, it's cups of love. And, you know, Gemini, what we see here is that you're in this energy, or excuse me, this is Aquarius energy. You feel as though this person hasn't been really honest with you. As far as you're concerned, you're just going day to day. You're taking everything a day at a time and moving forward. But right now, you have your back turned to this person. So let's look and see what we have for if they can win you. Let's look at the energy of whether your person can win you. The devil energy. Let's clarify that devil. Let's bring this right out here. And Gemini, tell us your feeling about that devil card and where you're at with it. Because you feel the person's manipulative. You feel as though they're trying to win your love by offering you things and, you know, tangible items. And that's just not where you're at in your head. And we see the death card. See, you're not having it. You're not having any devil energy. Any toxicity, they're going to have to check at the door. They're going to have to heal it. They're going to have to be balanced with you. They're definitely, you're not going to enter into that energy that gives them the upper hand. You are coming in with this beautiful Queen of Wands energy. You know, you're fiery, you're passionate, you're your own person. And unless they're balanced with you, unless they're honest with you, unless they treat you as a complete equal, you're just not going to give them the time of day. Why do we have the Seven of Swords card here for our Gemini friends in terms of your person's actions? What is it? What does that mean? Why would, what would they lie about? Nine of Wands. They want to win at all costs. They have fire in their belly. Let's see what else we need to know. The Two of Cups, well, they want to win your heart. The Two of Cups is here, you know, in the relationship. It is all about loving you, trusting you, sharing with you, opening their heart to you. So it does look like they get out of this manipulative energy. They treat you like the Queen of Wands that you are, and they work to win your heart, not only through tenacity, moving slowly into the future by being reliable. They have fire in their belly. But the Two of Cups, again, very much a twin flame, soulmate energy. And that's what they're bringing to the table. So Gemini, tell me what you think below. Tell me, I am doing personal readings. I'm going to send you love from Chicago. Send some back from wherever you're at in the world. And tell me what you think of the reading, if it resonated. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.